Hi everyone, and welcome to part two of the Endoskeleton Terminator Diorama. So last we left off, we just finished off the endoskeleton. I still have to do the teeth, which we'll do that in a minute. But I also had another idea, which we're going to go and have a look at now on the bench. So let's head over. So, I had the Arnold Terminator figure, which I've stripped down at the moment. I've just reopened up his eye as well. But we have the endoskeleton legs, and they just fit nicely inside Arnold like this. I'll just move it up a bit. So I'm thinking about incorporating this as well, but it needs quite a bit of work to these legs because they are old. They need stripping. They need stripping. Redoing, but I'm going to go in with some of this aluminium tubing, cut all this junk out here because that's twisted up pretty badly there, and replace it all with aluminium tubing, which should be pretty good. I think from memory, I think that's a join, so I can take them off, and I don't think. Yeah, that's all one piece. So I thought the knee bent, but I don't think it does. Because what I had in mind was something like, because I don't want this to be a good guy. I want it to be an evil Terminator. But I thought I might have him standing on this endoskeleton here. Something like on the lines of that. I've got myself some skulls sorted out, so they should be arriving on Wednesday. So I've got some human skulls in the same scale, so they could be scattered around. But maybe have this one standing on this one, maybe, or maybe just have it separate altogether on the base and then build up a wall or something. I'm in two minds on what to do with his arms. I might just leave them. But the leather jacket's going to have to go, so we're going to have to alter that slightly. And I might make it into like a tech com jacket. So he's trying to blend in still with the humans, even though he's half, literally half machine sort of thing. So if I get some expanding foam and just pop it inside there, that should take care of that. And we can have blood and guts and stuff or what have you, but it looks pretty good. So guys, I'm going to do like a little experiment. I've also painted the teeth, by the way, but we'll get to that in a minute. I've sprayed some Molotow Chrome, so yeah, nice and shiny. What I'm going to do is mask off this section, use the Plasticoat gloss to see what kind of reaction we get with that, and the other one we'll be doing with the Alclad 2 gloss on this one. Because I was talking to a guy on Facebook, and he says you can use lacquers on it. Now, my understanding of this stuff is every time I've tried to use a lacquer on it, you lose that shine and it dulls it. Because if the Alclad gloss works on it, I might just repaint the Terminator in the Alclads, because I can gloss it. Once that sets up, I can actually do my weathering on it. Now, it's a shame because I've got all this patina going on with it. Not that you're going to see that much light, but yeah, we'll just see what that, we'll see what the samples hold, but yeah, the teeth are done anyway, so that's good. They need a matte coat and then black wash. But yeah, I'm going to go and try this out now, and I'll let you know it comes out. Well, I have to say, guys, I'm very surprised. As you can see, either one's worked. That was the Plasticoat clear coat gloss, and that was the Alclad. I mean, the painting's uneven, like, so that's the dark patch, but as you can see in the sun under the light, they both worked. So I have to apologize for all the misinformation I've said. You can actually clear coat this stuff, which makes me think maybe I should just do it to the T-800 that's damaged there. It'd certainly look more in keeping with the T-800. So yeah, possibly do that. I'll just have to move you over a second. Oh, and then my phone's ringing, so we'll be right back. Right, we're back again. Where was I? Yeah. Yeah, it turns out that you can actually clear coat it. So, before I do that, I am going to leave this a while. I did the hairdryer on it, so that one's actually dry now, but there's reflections in it, so same with that one. If I had to put money on it, I would say the Alclad 2 probably is better, because I can see my finger, the reflection of my finger in that very easily, and this one, it is a bit dull, so I'd probably go with the Alclad. So it looks like he's going to get a respray. So the question is, what do I do with that? What can I do? I could maybe do salt technique again, but I mean, I don't know. I mean, if anything, they'll just look like bumps on his head. So I don't think it really matters that much. And I would like to use the chrome on it, because I was going to chrome Arnold over here. I don't have any purple power, so I couldn't strip all this paint off, but it has cleaned it up a lot. His eye is a little bit bigger now, so he's going to be throwing out a lot of red light there. But, you know, I can easily mask all this off, paint the jacket in the Tekcon colours, which I've just basically picked out like a medium blue for like a base colour, and then dark sea grey, I think, and just do like patches on it. The zippers will be painted in black, but yeah, he's going to look pretty cool. I'll clad all the metal on him to keep it in keeping, but yeah, so yeah, we'll be back as soon as I got a bit further. Hi guys, I'm just going to check this out again. Yeah, it looks really cool, and you can see the reflection of my finger in that, so I think I am going to go ahead and re-chrome him. I'll finish off the teeth, black wash them, get it matte coated, and then get them masked off, and then I think I'm going to use the Molito chrome. On another note, the legs are completely stripped down now from the Alclad chrome. I'm just going to have to clean these areas up, and then figure out a way of working with this leg. I opened all these up as well, by the way, because on the original kit these are all filled in, so I had to cut it all out. But if we're going to have Arnold standing on this one, the pelvis thing area here, his leg's going to have to come out here, and then his leg's going to have to come down like this, so something like that. So what I'm going to have to do is cut this section off and reposition it at an angle, which is going to leave a gaping hole here. So I'm going to have to use plenty of filler in that to sort that out. Another one is, I need to find out his final position as well. So it's going to be very awkward working all this out, because he's going to be stood about here. See if I can just mock it up quickly. If I get it shoved in jacket. Something like that. So we're going to have a leg coming out here like that, and then the other leg on like that. So yeah, got to try and work that one out. But everything's stripped down now and ready. His left leg will be fairly easy, because he's just going to be stood up on the ground. And a special thank you to Carwin if you're watching. I do really appreciate the skulls. I was searching for 1/5 scale human skulls to put on the base, and the ones that I found were just incredibly expensive, and I didn't really want to be spending all that. But Carwin kindly printed me off 5 skulls, so we've got some human skulls to scatter around, build loads of debris like rocks, bricks, whatever. And I'm thinking about getting in touch with Richard as well at Magic Scale Modelling, because I found a sound file that's basically all the cutscenes of the war. So you've got all the plasma rifles firing in the background, people dying, just to create a war scene. And I might see if I can get him to wire me up some purple LEDs that'll flash or something randomly, and then all the chrome will pick that light up. I'll just have to bury LEDs in the ground somewhere so it shines up at them. But yeah, all that good stuff. So a little project again has turned into a massive deal. So at some point I will just do a simple build, but I don't know when that's going to be, because the next one's going to be even bigger, because that'll be the Hellraiser. But another thing with Arnold as well is I think I'm going to take this arm off, and I'll probably have to use something like a skewer and put it into his actual hand like that. So while he's stood on this machine, his arm's going to be out here and he's going to be stabbing this Terminator with it. So it was, and he'll also have his foot on there as well. So it'd be something like that. Because otherwise these two machines are on a base together, but they're not really interacting with one another. I might as well have him stabbing this one and putting it out of its misery. Seeing as though it's useless without legs. So, yeah. I think I'm going to get off now, get some more work done, and we'll be right back. Hi guys. So I've hooked up a flickering LED now to the red eye, so it makes sense once the spike is going through the back of him that he's losing power. So we've got that done now. We've got the LED just here that's running that. And then obviously we've got the back going. We've also got Arnold's eye all lit up now. So that's looking pretty good. So I'm happy with the progress so far. I've gone ahead and used like the 30 gauge magnet wire, because the, which leg will it be? It'll be this leg here. On this leg, I'm going to have to drill through the ball joint there and run that magnet wire like inside, probably just against there, all the way down the leg. And then obviously run it down into the ball joint there, and then into the base. So that's pretty much where I've got to now. I do need to do the feet and cut all those sections out like I said, and replace it with some aluminium tubing, which is just the same stuff that I use for Ed. And that's pretty much it so far. There's a lot going on at the moment. a lot of fiddly stuff to do, and then I can move on to the good stuff. But I really do like his eyes there. They're trying to like power up and then fade. So that's pretty cool. So we'll be right back shortly, guys. Hi guys, and we're back. And I'm trying to glue this joint, because it's not straight. It has a slight bend in it, because this leg is going to be stood on this T800. And with it being PVC vinyl, it's a really crappy material to work with, because it doesn't want to glue. So I've had this on for ages now, and I still don't think it'll be... Nah, is it heck? So I'm going to have to put some kind of support inside there. But on another note, we have our little human-looking skulls. Now, Carwin posted these yesterday and they've already arrived. Obviously, you better see them better once they've got some primer on them, but yeah, really, really cool quality. Just reinforces the fact that I need a 3D printer. But thank you very much, Carwin, these are brilliant. I'm going to be removing some of the jaws on some of them. So they're going to be laid around on the base like that. Ooh. Yeah, just knock it with the cover. So thank you, Carwin. Much appreciated. So yeah, it's just a case of getting this bloody thing to join. I redid Arnold's arm yesterday, so that's been redone. Although I can't remember for the life of me why I did it so far out. If anything, it should have been inward. But so I don't know what I'm doing about that yet. I might have to snap it off and reposition it, or stick it in some boiling water and just reshape the whole thing. But yeah, everything's moving on pretty good now. I'm just trying to sort out this join. But I think for this update, I think that'll be about it, because, oh, tell you what, I forgot to tell you as well. We swapped all the junk out and replaced it with aluminium tubing, so at least it's nice and strong now. So, that's good. I'm just going to see if I can work out something with this leg joint here. So, we'll be right back. And welcome back, guys. So, what I've got done is we've actually got some primer down on the skulls now, which look pretty cool. We've also got the endo leg in primer now, and if you look over there, we've got Arnold, who's getting the shaft. We've also started doing some filler work on the leg. I finally got it glued. What I did is I put a bit of sprue in there as well, just to help support it. We've put an extra section in here, and we've also put the hydraulics in as well. So that's going to set up. I'm going to leave this overnight. I also need to get myself some expanding foam. I do have some, but I don't know whether I've got enough to fill the cavity of Arnold. I just want to pour some in there, and then we can level that off, put it all together, and then I can put some putty work over it and make blood guts and stuff. But yeah, if we have a close look at these skulls, you know, I really do need a 3D printer. Still need a lot of work doing to them, but yeah, really, really happy with them. I'll just zoom you back out because it won't focus, I don't think. But yeah, some cleaning up work to do just to get rid of the print marks, but on the whole, very, very happy. I'm going to be taking off the jaw of a few of these and having them scattered around on the floor. But yeah, thank you, Carwin, they're excellent. Really love them. And that's basically all I can get done today. The expanding foam I've got is this thing. But when I shake it, it doesn't seem to be moving around. So hopefully it works. But yeah, I'm just going to fill the cavity of the body. And get all that filled in there. Let this glue give that time to set up as well. And then I think the jacket is going to be like a dark green, like an army jacket. But yeah, I think for this update, I think that'll be it, because I really can't do any more. I'll sort that out afterwards. Yeah, I mean, I cleaned up the leg, got that in primer. Got to do the same with the other side. And yeah, that's basically it, guys. So I'll catch you in the next one. See you later.